Welcome all once again. We'll be designing in today's session, we will be designing a belt conveyor for which the specification is as said. A 25 degree incline roughing belt conveyor has the following specification. The specifications are given. Material conveyed is stone. Maximum lump size of the stone is given as 80 mm. The capacity for which the belt conveyor is to be used is 300 ton per hour. That means we need to transmit 300 tons of stone per hour. And inclination of the conveyor is 12 degrees. Inclination of the conveyor is 12 degrees. And the center to center distance is 40 meter. With this specification, we have to design the complete belt conveyor assembly, right? So we have already seen the steps involved in designing a belt conveyor. We will just start with the given things, and then we will move forward to design the belt conveyor. So what is given to us is a 25 degree roughing belt conveyor. 25 degree roughing belt conveyor. As we have seen, there are 2-3 types of belt conveyor. Wait a second. Someone is doing some type of mischief. Yes. So given to us is a 25 degree roughing belt conveyor. So as you all know, there are three different angles for a roughing belt conveyor: 25 degree, 35 degree, 45 degree, as per the PSG, right? And then the material which is to be conveyed is given as stone. So stone is to be conveyed, right? It is having a maximum size, lump size of 80 mm. The stone is having a lump size of 80 mm. And the capacity of the stone given to us is, capacity of stone which is to be conveyed by the belt conveyor is 300 tons per hour. Right, and then the inclination of the conveyor is given. These conveyors are mostly inclined to the x-axis, to the horizontal you can say, and center to center distance is given, that is 40 meters. Right, so in the very first step we need to draw the diagram of the belt conveyor. So I will just start with that. Step number one, that is your construction, you can say construction of the conveyor. Right, so a very simple construction is given to us. Draw the necessary parts of the conveyor and its mounting, which is required, without which the conveyor won't work. So we have two pulleys with us, two important pulleys without which the conveyor won't work, right? A head pulley and a tail pulley. This is your head pulley. Always the head pulley will be here only, and this is your tail pulley. It will remain here only. That depends whether you want to convey the material up or down. Based on that, your head pulley's rotation will change. If you want to convey up, it will move up. It will move in that direction. If you want to convey down, it will move in opposite direction. Right? If you want to convey up, the pulley, head pulley will move in clockwise direction. If you want to transmit the material down, it will rotate in anti-clockwise direction. Now this is your belt that is mounted on the pulleys. While the time of return, what we are doing is we are trying to adjust the length of the belt using some type of mountings, right? So here, to increase the lap, we are using one pulley which is known as snub pulley. To increase the angle of lap,
sir, camera.
Right,
sir, camera.
to increase the angle of lap, we are using one pulley, that is snap pulley. Here to bend the belt, we are using two pulleys. They are known as bend pulley. Right, and here to keep your belt tight, if your belt is loosening because of creep and slip, we are using one pulley that is known as take up pulley. So there are different types of take up pulley, gravity take up pulley, self weight take up pulley, and so on. Anyone can be used, right? Anyone can be used for this. These are the main parts, and there are few more pulleys or idlers, you can say, which are mounted. Here they are mounted. They are known as truffing idlers. They are main parts. The truffing idlers. Their function, as the name suggests, is just to be idle on their place and help the transmission. And here we will be having some return idlers. Return idlers are less in number. Return idlers can also be known as straight idlers, because they are straight, they are not inclined. The function of return idler is just to guide your belt, which is while it is in return condition, right? And then some few cleaning objects are attached here for cleaning the belt when it is in the return stroke. The belt will convey some material. It will put your material down over here, and then the belt will be scrubbed with some cleaning material. You can also say this as scrubber. Scrubber is nothing but the one element which will clean your belt, right? Primary cleaner, secondary cleaner. So these are the important parts which you have to draw when before going for the designing of the belt, right? So these things are clear. Things are clear to you what we are going to design. Yes, all are awake. All are awake.
ये 25 degree angle जो बोला ये तो standard नहीं है ना?
But then if as per requirement you have to take into consideration that angle, that is your truffing angle. So
क्या बोल रहे हो?
अगर स्टैंडर्ड नहीं दिया हुआ है और बोला हुआ है उसने उसके स्पेसिफिकेशन के अकॉर्डिंग, तो हमको वो लेकर डिजाइन करना पड़ेगा. यू हैव टू डिजाइन यूजिंग दैट एंगल. गेटिंग द पॉइंट? दिस इज द व्यू, फ्रंट व्यू ऑफ ए ट्रफिंग आइडलर. इट विल बी हैविंग थ्री ट्यूब्स फॉर द help of moving your object. Here the angle between the horizontal and the inclination of this tube is your truffing angle. This is your truffing angle, right? This is your truffing angle, which is being said in the question, that is 25 degrees set. So this is your diagram of a truffing idler. So this is 25 degree is not standard which is available in PSG, but if it is asked in the question that you have to design using that angle, you have to design using that angle. Not a big deal, just take that angle into consideration. Okay, and one more inclination is given, this 12 degrees. This is actually the inclination of your belt conveyor with the horizontal. So this is your 12 degrees. This is your 12 degrees inclination. With the ground, it is inclined at an angle of 12 degrees. Center to center distance is given, lump size, stone, and the capacity is given. So, any doubts? Still, you have any doubts? Yes. Okay. So, moving on, in the very next step, what we need to do is you need to go for the assumptions. What we need to assume is the density of the stone. Material is given to us, so stone density we have to take into consideration using PSG 9.22. Stone density 9.22. So you have your check with your PSG 9.22. I will guide you to the PSG. जस्ट सेकेंड, you all check with your PSG on 9.22, what is the density given to you?
अर्थ ड्राइव में चेक करना सर, स्टोन बोल के तो दिया नहीं है।
दिस इज योर स्टोन, ओ सॉरी, दिस इज योर 9.22, या यू कैन सी ग्रेवल्स, ग्रेवल्स आर गिवन। Right, limestone is there, many more are there, specifically about stone it is not said, so we can take gravels because gravels is also a type of stone. So for the gravel, the density, see, angle is also incline is recommended, maximum angle of bend in horizontal is 12 degrees, right? So also in the question 12 degrees is there, so we can take gravels into consideration. And then the density is in the range 1.5 to 1.9. Let us assume it as 1.6 tons per meter cube. Okay? Tons per meter cube. So this is one thing. Next thing what we need to assume is on PSD 9.20. That is the velocity we have to assume. Or you can say conveyor speed we need to assume. So the conveyor speed, if you can see on the screen, allowable belt conveyor speed in meter per second is based on the type of material conveyed as well as the width of the belt ki width par dependent hai. To agar aap dekhoge to belt width hai 400 500 650 and so on. So if nothing is said, let us take belt width, assume karna hai, belt width bhi assume karna hai, next step mein check karenge hum log whether the assumed things are perfect or not. Let us take 650 mm as the belt's width, and for the stone, any one velocity you can take, gravel stone, first velocity, that is 2 meter per second. Getting the point? You have to assume three things: stone density from 9.22, belt width from 9.20, and conveyor speed from 9.20. I'm coming back to the screen. This, so here I have written stone density I have assumed from 9.22, conveyor speed I have assumed from 9.20. And belt width I have assumed from 9.20. Yes, things are clear. Now, moving on to the next step, we will check whether this assumed things is fulfilling our requirement of designing the belt conveyor or not. So we will go for the width of belt. See, there are few things which we need to assume. This width we have assumed because we needed the conveyor speed. Without that, we would not have proceeded with the width. Therefore, we have assumed the width and we have assumed the speed. If our width is coming less than this, that means 650 mm will be sufficient and speed will be sufficient. If our belt width in this step will be coming more than this, then we will again go to the table on 9.20 and change our width and speed. Right, now if you want to calculate the minimum width of belt, there is one formula on 9.18. Minimum width of belt on 9.18. Please check with 9.18.
सर
आया है क्या आंसर अब्दुल्ला?
नहीं रे भाई।
हेलो क्या हुआ सर, कहाँ गए? अच्छा
आएंगे आएंगे है मेरे को
0.53 आंसर आया।
माय माइक वाज ऑफ एंड आई वाज जस्ट स्पीकिंग समथिंग। ओके सो 9.18 सी द बी मिनिमम मिनिमम विड्थ मिनिमम विड्थ ऑफ द बेल्ट। सो कॉपी दैट फॉर्मूला, दिस फॉर्मूला 9.18 1.11 1.11 into Q by CV, that is rho CV, rho is missing, raised to half plus 0.05, right? The whole bracket closed. What is Q? What is rho? What is C? What is V is written here. What is Q? Q is the density, right? Density we have to assume. What is C? Factor
Answer
for the type
Q
of outlet.
capacity.
Yes?
Q is the capacity of the conveyor.
Rho. Rho is density. Q is capacity. Q is conveyor capacity. V is belt speed. And C is factor for the type of idler. If you can see type of idler for 25 degrees, 5, 1, 10. Right? So Q we have as 300, which is given in the question, 300 ton per hour. Rho we have assumed as 1.6. C is the factor on your screen, you can see, which is 510. And V is the speed, that is 2 meter per second. Right? So after substituting everything, you will get your value of B minimum. So substitute everything and get the value of B minimum. Zero
सर
point five
पॉइंट
three.
फाइव थ्री मीटर्स
One second. What?
जीरो पॉइंट फाइव
पॉइंट
थ्री
फाइव थ्री मीटर्स
ओके सो बी मिनिमम यू आर गेटिंग एज 530 mm, राइट? बी मिनिमम यू आर गेटिंग एज 530 mm, एम आई राइट?
यस सर।
सो दैट मीन्स एनी वेज यू हैव टू गो एंड सेलेक्ट फॉर द स्टैंडर्ड विथ विच इज ऑन 9.0 9.20 सॉरी स्टैंडर्ड विथ, बराबर है? तो स्टैंडर्ड विथ जो हमने लिए है वो प्रॉपर है, मतलब जो 650 हमने अज्यूम किए है ना, दैट इज ए प्रॉपर स्टैंडर्ड विथ। आई विल शो यू अगेन स्टैंडर्ड विथ, यू कैन सेलेक्ट फ्रॉम दिस टेबल, आइदर फ्रॉम 9.19 और 9.20, ऑल द विथ्स आर सेम। सो इफ यू कैन सी 400 500, 650, and our coming is 530. Therefore, our selected standard width is proper, right? You just need to check in this step whatever we have assumed is correct or not, right? So our standard width is 650 mm, which we have already selected, right?
So कम रहेगा तो lower value लेने का या higher value के साथ चलेगा?
कम रहेगा, अगर 500 से कम होता तो 500 लेते हैं।
अच्छा तो फिर मतलब फिर स्पीड और वो वापस से चेंज करना पड़ेगा।
यस फ्रॉम 9.20 यू नीड टू चेंज द स्पीड एंड द विड्थ। Okay. So now, if you can see, our speed which we have assumed is correct, as well as the width which we have assumed is correct. Now, one more thing you need to take into consideration, that is weight of belt, which is on 9.19. Weight of the belt, which is on 9.19. See here. Weight of conveyor belt, that is 9 kgf per meter. Table number 1, 9 kgf per meter. So 9 kgf per meter is the width of belt. Getting the point? Weight is important. It is required in the next step, which is your total resistance to the belt step. Okay, so go to the next step. Things are clear till now?
Yes, sir.
Okay, so moving on to the next step. Next step is crucial as well as a bit lengthy. Not to worry, just move. It has different parts. Sub step number 1, weight of revolving part. See, what we are trying to find, resistance is nothing but the tension in the belt or the weight on the belt, right? Humne tension find karte na normal bend karne mein, T1 by T2 is equal to e raised to mu theta, or T1 T2 find karte hai, waisa hai ye. But isme aisa hai ki hamare paas revolving parts hai, we have return idlers, then we have weight of the belt, then we have weight of the material. So everything we have to take into consideration, and then we need to go for calculation or addition of all these things using some formula which is available in PSG. So if you see, in the very first sub step we are going for weight of revolving parts, you can say weight of revolving parts. Revolving means the parts which are rotating. So the parts which are rotating are nothing but your troughing idlers. They will be having tubes, as I said, they will be having 3 tubes, one tube over here, one tube over here, and the one tube over here. This tube will rotate around the axis, right? So just see what is the weight of troughing idlers. What are the weight of troughing idlers? You can go into PSG. 9.19, you have to assume few things, and based on that you have to take the value. Go to PSG 9.19. See, weight of revolving parts of idlers. So there are two different, in table number 2, two things are given: troughing idlers or straight idlers, right? So we are now concerned about troughing idlers, right? We are now concerned about troughing idlers. So for the troughing idlers, he says you need to assume, first thing is the belt width, which we have already calculated, that is 650. Tube diameter you have to assume, and bearing diameter you have to assume. So let us assume tube diameter and bearing diameter. So I will tell you one tube diameter and bearing diameter for assumption. Remember that and assume that always. So let us take as tube diameter as 125 mm and bearing diameter as 20 mm. If required, we will change that. Based on 125 and 20, for 650, the answer is 17.9. Weight is 17.9 kg per idler assembly. See the unit, kg per idler assembly, right? kg per idler assembly. If you can see, I have assumed tube diameter, I have assumed bearing diameter, and then I have taken weight from that table, which is on PSG 9.19, table number 2. that is 17.9 kg per idler assembly, right? So now my concern is, this is weight per idler assembly. We want weight per meter length. Weight per meter length चाहिए हमको. So we need to see at what distance the idler assembly are mounted. So I will tell you, spacing between roughing idlers, just remember, it is always 1.5 meters. एक आइडलर असेंबली से दूसरा आइडलर असेंबली 1.5 मीटर के डिस्टेंस पे होता है. जैसे हमने डायग्राम में बनाया ना, आइडलर्स बनाया, ऐसे तीन चार आइडलर बनाया, तो ये दोनों आइडलर्स के बीच का जो डिस्टेंस है ना, वो 1.5 मीटर है. हमको क्या चाहिए? वेट पर मीटर लेंथ चाहिए, बराबर. तो इसको आपको इसको इससे डिवाइड करना पड़ेगा ताकि आपको वेट पर मीटर लेंथ मिल जाए, ठीक है. तो ये हरदम आपकी जो असेंबली होती है वो 1.5 मीटर की दूरी पर ही होती है, मिनिमम 1.5 मीटर की दूरी पर होती है, उससे ज्यादा भी हो सकती है. एक टेबल है, जब उसकी जरूरत पड़ेगी मैं आपको बताऊंगा क्या वो कितने कितने डिस्टेंस पे हो सकती है. सी, नीचे लिखा हुआ है 9.19 पे, स्पेसिंग फॉर आइडलर मैक्सिमम स्पेसिंग फॉर आइडलर. If you can see in that table, density of material for 1.6, for 650 the spacing is 1.5, right? So from 9.19 we have taken this spacing. And for return idler, if you can see on the right side, for return idler, for all the weight, the spacing is 3 meter. ठीक है, ये भी जरूरत पड़ेगा आपको आगे. Spacing is 3 meter. For return idler, right? So now, if you can see, as I told you, we need weight of roughing idler per meter length. So weight of roughing idler per meter length. That is, if you can see in your PAG, it is given as this denotation, GRO. So 17.9 kg per idler assembly, 1.5 meter distance. And what we will do is, we will convert the kg into Newton. So multiply by 9.81, so it becomes kg, so it becomes Newton per meter. So now calculate the value in Newton per meter. Calculate, I will be back. I'm just stopping the screen sharing. You calculate it. So what is the answer you are getting?
One one seven point zero six
Newton per meter. Okay. So this is one part. Now we will do the same thing for return idlers.
सर सर यहाँ पर अपने को अक्रॉस द लेंथ रहना चाहिए ना, तो ये तो अपन ने बस दो ट्रफिंग आइडलर्स के बीच में निकाले।
वेट ऑफ लेंथ के लिए एक फार्मूला है बाद में पीएलजी में दिया हुआ, पहले पर मीटर लेंथ सबका पर मीटर लेंथ सबका वेट निकालना है, फिर वो सारे वैल्यूज उस इक्वेशन में सब्स्टिट्यूट करना है, वो अक्रॉस द लेंथ आपको पूरा वेट दे देंगे। एक फॉर्मूला है बताता हूं मैं, ठीक है
जी सर। अच्छा इधर पर मीटर लेंथ बोला है तो डिवाइड बाय 1 नहीं करने का, मतलब 1.5 ही करने का जो उसका स्पेस है।
पर मीटर लेंथ फाइंड करने के लिए इसने वेट किसमें दिया है हमको, केजी पर आइडलर असेंबली, तो आइडलर असेंबली का जो डिस्टेंस है उससे डिवाइड करेंगे ना तो वो मीटर में आ जाएगा।
मीटर में आ जाएगा बराबर।
तो अभी नाउ वी नीड टू कैलकुलेट वेट ऑफ स्ट्रेट आइडलर्स, वेट ऑफ स्ट्रेट आइडलर्स। So as we have proceeded, in the same way we have to proceed, go for 9.19, assume two values, get the weight from 9.19, then see the spacing and divide that weight by that spacing. If you want Newton mein, to multiply by 9.81, same step. ठीक है, तो आप 9.19 पे जाके मुझे अभी weight of state idler बताइए कितना आ रहा है। ट्यूब डायमीटर 1.25, रेन डायमीटर इतना ही रखना है,
11 आ रहा
है। सो इट इज द वेट यू आर गेटिंग फ्रॉम 9.19, प्लीज कंफर्म वंस।
11
ओके। जुल्फिकार सिद्दीकी, जुल्फिकार समवन ऑफ दिस नेम इज देयर,
नो सर ही इज नॉट देयर।
क्या नाम है उनका बेटा, जुल्फिकार सिद्दीक
सर, जुल्फिकार सिद्दीकी है उसका नाम।
ओके ठीक है चले, ओके नो प्रॉब्लम। सो 11 केजी पर आइडलर असेंबली वेट इज वी हैव गॉट। Also on the same page, see the spacing for return or state idlers. As I have told you, it will remain 3 meter for all the lengths from 9.19. Now go for weight of return idlers or straight idlers per meter length. Right.
35.97 newton per meter.
GRU is there. 11 into 9.81 divided by 3. 35.9 newton per meter. ठीक है। All are done till here. Can we move? In the next step, just we have to see the weight of belt per meter that we have already got in the previous step, step number 3. So our weight of belt per meter is 9 into 9.81 to convert that into Newton per meter. This is in kg per meter. done. Now the last weight is left, weight of the material, and then we can add everything to get the resistance of belt on top.
Sir, ye weight of belt per meter kahan se aaya?
See, in step number 3 we have taken that from 9.19. step number 3 jab hi humne weight aur velocity liye to wahan par weight bhi liye the. In the last point mil gaya?
Haan sir, mila.
Now the in the last point, weight of material per meter length. Weight of material per meter length, that is GG. हमको capacity दी हुई है ना? We have been given the capacity as 300 tons per hour. Sorry, 300 tons बराबर. तो ये kg में हो गया, टन से kg में हो गया, kg से न्यूटन में हो गया. ऊपर का काम हो गया न्यूटन में, नीचे का मीटर में करना है. सो दिस इज मटेरियल. मटेरियल कहां पर होता है? रफिंग आइडलर्स पे होते हैं या रिटर्न आइडलर्स पे होते हैं?
रफिंग
रफिंग रफिंग आइडलर. तो इसका जो डिस्टेंस रहेगा वो 1.5 रहेगा. और तो ये हो गया मीटर में. बट ये जो दिया था ना 300 टर्न्स पर आवर्स दिया था, तो उसको भी कन्वर्ट करना पड़ेगा. 300 टर्न्स पर आवर्स था, तो उसको हमने केजी पर मीटर में कन्वर्ट करके बाद में न्यूटन पर मीटर में कन्वर्ट कर दिया. सो दिस इज द कन्वर्जन ऑफ टर्न पर आवर, दिस इज द कन्वर्जन ऑफ न्यूटन पर मीटर. न्यूटन और मीटर वी हैव टेकन 1.5 बिकॉज द मटेरियल विल बी कन्वेड ऑन द टॉप आइडलर, नॉट ऑन द बॉटम आइडलर. So if you can solve this, you will get the answer.
545.
So what 3600 ke liye?
It is to convert from hours to minute. Sorry, not minute, second. 60 into 60. Hours to minute, minute to second. Per second per meter.
सर ये अपना जो जी बी है वेट ऑफ बेल्ट, तो वो उसको भी न्यूटन पर मीटर में कन्वर्ट करना है?
हाँ, सब न्यूटन पर मीटर में कन्वर्ट कर दो. तो लास्ट में जब हम लोग सब्स्टिट्यूट करेंगे तो हमारे लिए इजी पड़ेगा, आंसर हमारे को न्यूटन पर मीटर में मिलेगा. ओके, नाउ now as Abdullah said, now you can see the resistance of belt on top side. The formula is available on 9.18. on the top layer of the belt, how much is the total resistance, weight on the top, weight on the top side of the belt? You can check with 9.18. I will write the formula. It is CFL into GG plus GB cos of delta plus GRO plus minus HGG plus GB. You can check with this. This one bracket, this one bracket plus minus, and the entire bracket CFL plus minus SGG plus GB. GG and GB are there. Weight per meter length and weight of the belt. If you can see. right? And I will write what plus minus is the meaning. Plus will be used positive for conveying the material up, and negative for conveying material down. Right? This positive negative went to use. Now we have GG, we have GB, we have GRO. What about H, delta, C, F, and L? I will tell you, C is a factor, that is secondary resistance factor. This is tricky to see secondary resistance factor. A small diagram in PSG is given, and with the help of that, we need to calculate the secondary resistance factor. So if you can see on 9.18, there is a small graph. See this graph. This is a small graph. From that graph, we have to see, based on the length, we have to see the value of C. So it is not clear in this picture, but if you see in the PSG and take a screenshot of that PSG and then zoom it, you will be able to see it properly. For our length, I will tell you, for our length, the value of C is around 2.5, 2.6. So for now, don't get into that confusion. Just write 2.6 as the length. C, as the value of C as 2.6. What is F? F, I will tell you, it is friction between idler and belt. Friction between idler and belt. Again, it is on 9.18. Again, we will go to 9.18. Friction between idler and belt for standard conveyor, for non-portable conveyor, nothing is said. We will take standard conveyor, 0.02. Again, if we see what is the length is given to us in the question, that is 40 meter. Right? Now, only thing left is delta and H. So if you can see, delta is given as 12 degrees. We need to calculate height. So I will tell you, this is the conveyor, a line diagram of the conveyor I am drawing. This is your L, center distance. This is your delta. How much will be your H then? How much will be your H? Boliye.
Or supply करेंगे sir. Sorry, sine. Opposite upon hypotenuse. देखना अपने पास length ना length.
It is L sine of delta.
8.13 R है. H की value 8.13 sorry. 8.31.
8.316.
8.316 meters. सारी चीजें मिल गई. Substitute everything into this above formula and get the answer for me.
Sir, conveying up use karenge ke down?
Conveying up, hum log up kar rahe hai beta. If nothing is said, we always the material is conveyed up.
Sir, wo conveyor length 40 kaise liye apna?
Center to center distance kya hai na? ये लेंथ है कन्वेयर की, ये इतनी लेंथ होती है कन्वेयर बेल्ट की लेंथ नहीं, कन्वेयर की लेंथ की बात चालू है।
हाँ सर, वो शायद सी ग्राफ में देखे से लग रहा है अराउंड 1.2 है वो, मतलब पीएचडी की बुक में।
फिलहाल आप ले लो, अगर आपको 1.2 चाहिए आप 1.2 ले लो, नॉट ए बिग डील।
पीएचडी में छोटा सा ग्राफ है, वो जो लेंथ है वो सेंटर डिस्टेंस वाला लेंथ है क्या?
हाँ, लेंथ ऑफ कन्वेयर, लेंथ ऑफ कन्वेयर मतलब सेंटर डिस्टेंस वाला लेंथ, लेंथ ऑफ बेल्ट मतलब अलग होता है, लेंथ ऑफ कन्वेयर अलग होता है, लेंथ ऑफ बेल्ट अलग होता है।
हाँ सर, लेंथ ऑफ बेल्ट तो उसका दुगना आएगा और उससे ज्यादा थोड़ा।
हाँ, डबल आएगा उससे ज्यादा, डबल
6798.38
न्यूटन न्यूटन
न्यूटन
Someone please check, cross verify कर लो एक बार, आगे चलेंगे।
तो जब तक specify नहीं किया तब तक for conveying up के लिए ही करने का।
Yes, yes.
Down अगर बोलेगा तो करने का।
Down के लिए जब बोलेगा तभी करने का।
सर 6812.27
ऐसा 68 ठीक है, जो भी आ रहा है लिख लो 68, मेरा 6816.39 आया है। आपका जो भी आ रहा है आप लिख लो, नॉट ए बिग डील। Done? All are done till here?
Yes.
बोलिए, हो गया?
Yes, sir.
We will move on to resistance of belt on bottom. Again, go to PhD 9.18, get the formula of bottom.
Sir,
बोलिए।
Sir, ये जो अपन ने आंसर निकाले ये KGF में आया ना सर?
Newton में। We have substituted this values in Newton meter.
अच्छा अच्छा सर, yes.
If you substitute in kg, you will get in kg. ठीक है, check with your 9.18. I am writing the formula directly. This is the formula given. This is the formula given in PhD. CFL GB cos delta plus GRU plus minus SGB, again plus for conveying. Now here the plus minus will change because the return idlers will rotate in opposite direction of your top idlers. Top idlers जब convey up करेंगे तो return idler conveying down करेंगे, वो opposite direction में घूमते हैं। आया समझ में? ऐसा क्यों होता है? Because belt को फिर से ऊपर आना है। Now if belt is going up, belt को नीचे आना है। So here the signs positive will be for conveying down. Positive will be for conveying down, negative for conveying up. आया समझ में? Opposite लेना है। इधर अगर आपने पॉजिटिव अप के लिए लिए हो तो इधर भी पॉजिटिव ही लेना है, बट वो डाउन के लिए आएगा। वेल साइन सेम लेना है, अगर नेगेटिव ले रहे तो इधर नेगेटिव लेना है, अगर पॉजिटिव ले रहे तो इधर पॉजिटिव लेना है। सब्स्टिट्यूट कर दो सारी सेम वैल्यूज,
988.67.
What is the answer?
988.67.
Okay. Please confirm this.
Sir, minus I don't know. Plus minus के तो minus आएगा ना, अपने plus लिख दिया था, plus 90, minus 90 होगा ना?
ऐसे वही तो पूछ रहा हूँ ना मैं.
अच्छा इधर उल्टा प्लस फॉर कन्विंग डाउन.
हाँ
अच्छा ओके ओके, मेरे को लगा वो पहला वाला कंडीशन ही सेम रखना है, बस साइन अपोजिट डालना है.
नहीं नहीं, साइन सेम रखना है, कंडीशन चेंज हो जा रही. सो यू आर गेटिंग द सेम आंसर एवरीवन?
सर 1005.88.
1006.22. 1006.60. 1006 बोले क्या?
यस सर.
यस ठीक है, दोनों में से जो सही है आप वो ले लो. Okay, now finally what you need to do is add everything to get total resistance.